seven.
All right, here's what I want to do. I want to be able to help you, so I have to protect the integrity of your experience. So if you guys ask me a question, please feel free to make it as specifically general as possible, so that if I turn around and say to you, I have your significant other here, you can't say, or people around you can't say, well, you told them that. So for me, my job is to actually protect that, even with those who are open to the subject matter, because I want you to know that he would be okay with that, they would be okay. Now, go ahead.
Well, I'm still having a hard time.
Okay.
And I often tried to talk to this person.
Okay.
And you always hear of when somebody passes, like for myself, I'm having a very difficult time letting go. Am I keeping his spirit here?
A lot of people think that, because people in my field will let people think that because of the ego. And here's the bottom line. There is a real, I believe, divine matrix of possibility that happens when we leave this world. And I think that perspective is something that they shift slightly. And that 99% of the time, people when they make their transition, look at things a little differently than we would here on the earth plane. However, they love us very, very much, and they want us to be able to move on. And I always tell people, you never get over it. You never get over it. But you can learn to get on with it. So here's what I want you to know. I don't think there's any accident that I would pick you for the question. I don't think that, because I randomly pick people around the room. And here's what I want you to know. I don't know if somebody had the heart surgery or if somebody had something heart related. Who had the heart stuff going on?
Now? I kind of do.
Okay. Did they want to do an angiogram, or did they want to do something to check out what's happening chest related?
Yeah.
Okay. And have you postponed that because you're thinking, well, maybe if there's something wrong with me, then maybe I'll join the person sooner?
I'm not thinking that way, but I have to have another, what do you call it? I have AFib.
Okay.
And then I get the shock treatment. Now they have to do some kind of another treatment where they go through to the heart.
So then that would be a yes to everything I'm saying. Right? Okay.
Well, I'm not looking forward to leaving this earth anytime soon.
Okay. Say it again.
I'm not looking forward to leaving this earth anytime
That's
soon.
Good, because they're not looking forward to having you there anytime soon. So here's what I feel like. I think that your ability to actually heal people is actually pretty amazing. So I don't know what you've done with your life or what you do with your life now, but you have a very therapeutic, energetic healing aspect to yourself, whether it be, you know, touch or nursing or whatever it is. Healing and education to me are the same energy, because you're giving of yourself to help somebody else. You have that in such a beautiful way. So you're still needed here, but I also feel like you take on other people's stuff. And I feel like you have to find a way to let go of what you take on. You know, one night I came home and my wife was sitting at our dining room table, and she had a whole bunch of unopened letters in one hand and the cell phone, the cordless phone in the other, and she was crying. And I walked in and she went, you have to call these people right now and set up appointments. This one lost their father, this one lost their son. And I looked at her like, okay, first of all, I can't read those. And then second of all, everybody has a story. I said, and I have to say, I have to be in balance in order to be able to do what I do. You have to be in balance in order to do what you do. Otherwise, you become the giving tree. I don't think they should actually teach from that book in school. I hate that book. Because the message of that book is just keep giving until you're stuck. And I'm not okay with that. So like that book's not allowed in my house. I'm very verbal about that, because you could be selfless and giving, but remain in balance. You have to make sure you're well with your client so you can be in charge. Now, do you have a son?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Living, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Does he need to be slapped or something? Oh,
you sure read that right.
Now, one of the things that they do is they take me on a path and they prepare you. Don't be the giving tree. Your son needs to be slapped. Here's the thing. Part of our role as parents is to be able to raise awareness, to educate, to help, to heal, but to also make sure that we're putting our voices in their heads to make the right empowered decisions. I feel like you've done that, but I feel like there's a sense of entitlement that comes under that. And in some way, he might be looking for things. I don't know what it is, but I feel like a respect and responsibility and issues of that, take care of yourself, my friend. That's what I want to do. Now, the person that's passed, is that not your son's father?
No.
Okay. And where is Ben, or the B name? I could be off by names, but I will not be off by initials.
Where's the word? I'm sorry.
Who has the B name?
Ben.
I see initials. So who has the B name, like Ben or Benjamin or Ryan? Who is that person around you, either living or past?
I can't think of anyone.
Okay. Is your mom also past? No, the woman that I'm talking to.
Oh.
Remember, you have the microphone in your hand.
I'm not sure what's going on the inside.
I am. So, now, where's the B name for you, either living or past?
My mother is past.
Your mom has passed. Okay. I might be off by the name, but I won't be off what it sounds like. It sounds like a B with an N, like Ben, Bon, Ban, is a Bun, or something BN. So I don't know what this is, but if there's anything that's going to have a BN sound, now if there's any names that are going to be Hawaiian, please do not expect them to come out of me. I'll get it phonetically, because that's how I get the information. It sounds like phonics. It's like hooked on psychic phonics. That's how it comes out. So I want you to know that I have somebody who passes from cancer as well. So I don't know who the cancer passing is. Can you take the mic? Are you with her? Is your family jumping in, like over here? Dad, take the mic. Where's the B name?
My father-in-law passed away in June.
Where's the B name?
His name is Benjamin.
Benjamin. Okay. And did he have cancer?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you pregnant?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah. Now?
My dad passed away a month later.
Is there a reason why one of these men wants to show me an international flag? Now, let me say this. When I see an American flag...
They're in the army.
Okay.
Hold on.
Oh my God, I think I'm playing a game show. I have to get the answer out for you people. If they show me an American flag, it either means that somebody passed during military time or they were buried with the flag.
Yes.
I'm seeing an international looking flag. So, did somebody have... Did they pass overseas? Did somebody pass during wartime overseas? Was somebody, you know, a citizen of another country when they died in the military?
They're in the military.
Where?
I'm not sure where, but...
Okay, remember that I'm saying this, and don't be mean from what I'm saying.
Okay.
You know, the man that passed in June,
mm-hmm.
You said that was Benjamin?
Yes.
Benjamin also connected to the M name like Margaret or Mary or the M?
Yeah, his mom is Lily.
Okay, is his mom also passed?
No.
Okay, can you please let her know that he came through? But he did meet up with the father figure?
Yes,
so
yes.
Okay, I need to, they're together. It's important. Now, did you also lose a dog?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
His dog.
The dog is with him.
Yeah.
Oh,
right.
Did you all notice that the dog got the most honks? Put it out there. Just imagine how your family feels right now. Now, is this your second child?
Yes.
Okay. And is the middle name of this child going to be for both of them, or are you?
I was thinking about it, but
okay.
I'm not sure.
Here's what I want you to know. They don't need you to do that. Just the honor and the acknowledgement is enough. Okay. Now, I need to jump. So thank you guys very, very much. And I know I've got people upstairs to get to. Thank you. But I need to get a mic over there because somebody passed on a motorcycle over there. Somebody passed on this.